Hi friends, it's Sue at A Call to Create, and it's Friday, so time for a flip through of my personal journal, the first 2 weeks in September that I've been working on. The papers I've been using this time around are mostly scrapbook papers with kind of a fall feel to them. So I just had a small piece here for the first day. And I put a little gold doily here, and then I made a little file folder type thing for a journaling spot and glued that on there. Our daughter and son-in-law had come into town for the weekend, and so I just, we had breakfast out, and then they were catching their flight. So that was about all that was going on that day. The next day, Labor Day, my husband and I left for 5 days in Door County, Wisconsin. We go up there a lot. And so I do take my travel journal with me. I get some of it in, but I just do kind of the bare bones in here. And then I finish up the travel journal usually later on when I get back. But I do take some things with me that I think I might make use of. Here was some paper that you can purchase up there, some scrapbook paper. So I wanted to kind of get a little bit more room for day three and what we were doing and the pictures I was taking. Took those with my iPhone, and then I take along my little sprocket, and it prints out. I think these are 2x3 size photos. So so I put those in there and just did a little snapshot of what we did that day. The next day, again, you know, it's just not too much about, you know, what was going on, just the places we went to, where we went for dinner, what we were doing that day, some photos, that kind of thing. I go into a little more depth when I do the travel journal. So the next day, again, we went for a little hike. We tried to do a hike each day. And this was just, this was a greeting card, and I wanted a little more room here, a very small area, too small to write on. So I just, I had another little card in my stash that I glued in there to just kind of extend it a little bit, give me a little more room to write about what we did that day. And then I think this was something that I bought up there. Yeah, I found a bunch of, there's a store we go into, a resale shop, and all the greeting cards were 5 cents each with the envelopes. So I got a bunch of fall ones. And on the way home, we stopped at this place called Bookworm Gardens in Sheboygan, Wisconsin. And it's just these beautiful gardens, but they're all kind of built around the theme of children's books. So this one was the Three Little Pigs with their three houses, and this one, I don't know what it was, but two eyes here and my husband kind of standing in the mouth of whatever that was. So yeah, it's just, this is Frog and Toad, and it was a fun place that we had always wanted to stop and see. The next day we were home, and this is just an old postcard that I thought would look nice in here. It is from 1910, an actual postcard that was sent. It has some writing on there. I just glued in. There wasn't much going on that day. I wanted to keep this because I just like this picture. And Sunday, we never do much on Sunday. It's kind of our day of rest. So yeah, I wanted to keep this, you know, this is from an Edith Holden book, so I just wrote a little bit up there, and that was it for that day. The next day, we went to Wrigley Field. My husband is a huge Cubs fan, and his birthday was in August, but for his birthday, I purchased a tour of Wrigley Field for him. So I took some photos. We got to go into, we took some photos by the ivy walls out in on the field. And we got to sit in the press box. We went to the visitors. We went to the visitors' locker room, and then this was the Cubs' dugout. And then I took them out for lunch afterwards. So that was a big hit with him, because he is just an amazing Cubs fan. He did learn a few things, though. So, you know, he doesn't know everything about the Cubs. But the next day was just the debate and some thoughts that I had on that, which I won't go into. Wednesday this week, I just had this in my stash. I made a bunch of these long time ago, and this was just from a book, and I didn't put anything on there, but I just wanted to use it. It was so pretty. And you know, then I just wrote a little bit about what was going on that day. My granddaughter came over, and the next day. Yeah, and this is one of those things, this is supposed to have a two here. It reminds me of the gingerbread man, you know, how he hops off the cookie sheet and hops out of the oven and runs away. I had the two, I was about to stamp it, and it just disappeared. And I've searched all over my floor and my desk and everything. It'll turn up eventually, but so I just left room for it there. What are you going to do, right? Has that ever happened to you? So that's it so far. And yeah, I'm just going to continue with this, and I'll be back to show you what I'm doing. I am coming close to having 1,000 subscribers, and I have some giveaways planned for when that happens. So if you haven't subscribed yet, please think about doing that so that you are ready when the time comes. And till then, or till next time, thanks for coming along, and I'll see you next time.